सेकेंड प्रॉब्लम, एक्सप्रेस cos a to the power of 6 plus sin a to the power of 6 in terms of sin 2a. We have to express it in terms of sin 2a. Let us do it. So given cos a power 6 plus sin a power 6. Let us see, can we write like this? So cos square a whole cube 3 to the 6 plus sin square a whole cube. Just imagine if cos square a is equal to a, sin square a is equal to b. This will be in the form of a cube plus b cube. A cube plus b cube is nothing but a plus b whole cube minus 3ab of a plus b. This is one of the identities in algebra. We can call it as an algebraic identity. Here a for cos square a, b for sin square a. So this side we have to write it. Cos square a plus sin square a whole cube minus 3 cos square a into sin square a. Again cos square a plus sin square a. Now what is the value of cos square a plus sin square a? It's very easy. The cos square a plus sin square a is the fundamental trigonometric identity. So that's 1. So here 1 cube and multiplied by 1, we get 1 minus, this can be rewritten as 3 sin square a cos square a. Just check our problem. Problem must be sin 2a means, so here we have to change some mathematical manipulations. So in order to get sin 2a, better take only this term and multiply by 4, divide by 4. So this can be written as 1 minus 3 by 4 times 4 sin square a cos square a. Again just think, this 4 sin square a cos square a can be put 2 sin a cos a whole square. Now 1 minus 3 by 4 2 sin a cos a whole square. This is nothing but a formula. 1 minus 3 by 4 sin 2a whole square. So this is equal to 1 minus 3 by 4 sin square 2a. So now in terms of sin 2a we have expressed this problem. Hereafter we can remember cos a to the power of 6 plus sin a to the power of 6 is nothing but 1 minus 3 by 4 times sin square 2a. Third one. Express one minus cos theta plus sin theta by 1 plus cos theta plus sin theta in terms of tan theta by 2, tan of theta by 2. Let us do it. So now 1 minus cos theta plus sine theta by 1 plus cos theta plus sine theta. Here we have the formula for sin A in terms of some multiple angles. What is the formula? Do you expect it? Sin theta is equal to 2 sin of theta by 2 cos theta by 2, we can write it. In this manner, do you expect the formula for 1 minus cos to A and also 1 plus cos to A? Yes, we have the formula for 1 minus cos to A is 2 sin square A, whereas 1 plus cos to A is 2 cos square A. In terms of, think in terms of submultiple angles, so by 2 you will be getting. So now this 1 minus cos theta we can write 2 sin square theta by 2, and plus, whereas sin theta is 2 sin theta by 2 and cos theta by 2, and by here 1 plus cos theta is equal to 2 cos square theta by 2 and plus 2 sin theta by 2 cos theta by 2. Just check in the numerator. In the numerator, the 2 sin theta by 2 we can take out common. Check in the denominator, we can take 2 cos theta by 2 common. So if you take 2 sin theta by 2 common, we get sin theta by 2 plus cos theta by 2 by 2 cos theta by 2 common, we get cos theta by 2 plus sin theta by 2. Now what will you do? Here these two are the common factors. These two common factors are going to be cancelled. We get 1 gets cancelled, 1, 2 gets cancelled. So we have sin theta by 2 by cos theta by 2. What is the value of sin theta by 2 by cos theta by 2? That is nothing but tan of theta by 2. So this is equal to tan of theta by 2. So in terms of tan of theta by 2, we expressed this one. Now let us move to the next problem. So this is first problem. If sin alpha is equal to 3 by 5, where pi by 2 less than alpha, alpha less than pi, evaluate cos 3 alpha and tan 2 alpha. Okay, let us find out. Now, here just check the problem. In the problem, sin alpha is given 3 by 5, positive. That is positive, am I correct? And that too, alpha lies in between 90 degrees to 180, means second quadrant. In the second quadrant, sine is positive, but whereas cos is negative. That means if you want to find out cos value, we have to write the negative sign for that one. So let us first find out cos alpha value using sin alpha value. Here, given that sin alpha is equal to 3 by 5 and also pi by 2 less than alpha, alpha less than pi, that implies alpha belongs to second quadrant. Now we know that cos square is equal to 1 minus sin square alpha. So that means this is 3 by 5. 1 minus 9 by 16, or 9 is 25, 9 by 25. So 16 by 25 cos square alpha. Let us find out cos alpha. Root over 16 by 25, which equal to plus or minus 4 by 5. Since alpha belongs to the second quadrant, the cos alpha is actually, since alpha belongs to second quadrant, cos alpha is less than 0. So therefore, cos alpha is equal to, we take it as minus 4 by 5. Similarly, if you want to write tan alpha also, is negative, tan alpha is equal to here, sin alpha by cos alpha we can write. So that is minus 3 by 4. Now we have to find out cos 3 alpha. So cos 3 alpha formula, 4 cos cube alpha minus 3 cos alpha, 4 multiplied by minus 4 by 5 whole cube minus 3 multiplied by minus 4 by 5. So very carefully we have to simplify this one. So 4 multiplied by minus 4 cube is minus 64, 5 cube is 125. Am I correct? Minus into minus plus 12 by 5. Here 125 is the LCM. This is 256 minus plus 525. 25 into 12, 300 minus 256, let us do it. So now 300 minus 256, 4 and 44. So now this will be 44 by 125. This is cos 3 alpha. Now we have to find out sin 2 alpha. Tan 2 alpha. Tan 2 alpha is 2 tan alpha by 1 minus tan square alpha. What is tan alpha? Minus 3 by 4. So 2 multiplied by minus 3 by 4 and 1 minus minus 3 by 4 whole square. So now this equal to minus 6 by 4 by 1 minus 9 by 16. So minus 6 by 4, 16 is the LCM, 16 minus 9, minus 6 by 4 multiplied by 16 by 16 minus 9 is 7, 4 4 ja, minus 24 by 7. So both the values have been determined, cos 3 alpha as well as tan 2.